Hey guys, what's up and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Janine, and if you are not new, welcome back for a new video. I am so happy and grateful to have you here. Thank you to everyone who has subscribed to my new channel. I really do appreciate that. So in today's video, I want to talk about some beginner tips for new weight loss patients. So if you are thinking about getting weight loss surgery, or if you have just recently had weight loss surgery, then these tips are for you. And if you haven't recently had weight loss surgery, and maybe you're a few years out like myself, some of these tips are still going to be very beneficial for you, so don't stop watching just yet. Okay, so the first thing that we will talk about is number one, you have to start getting into the habit of eating your food very slowly. So if you haven't had weight loss surgery yet and you are anticipating getting it, then I would suggest that you start attempting to eat your food slowly now. So what I mean by that is taking at least 20 to 25 bites of every single bite of food that you take. And it's probably going to be very hard in the beginning, so that is definitely why I would suggest that you start it before you get your surgery. So like that, by the time that you actually get your surgery, you are already kind of aware of that process of eating your food slowly. And for those of us who are already a few years out, I don't know if you are like myself, but I'm actually able to eat pretty fast, so I'm not sure if that is a great thing. And yes, there are times where I keep needing to remind myself to eat slow, chew my food very well, and that seems to help when I keep reminding myself. The next thing that kind of goes along with eating your food slowly is not drinking with meals. So that is another tough one, because as time progresses and we get more comfortable with the sleeve, we start kind of testing the waters and kind of seeing, you know, what we can do, what's gonna bother us, what's not. And then you start to see that maybe if you start to drink with meals, maybe you're able to eat a little bit more. So depending on what you're drinking, even though you shouldn't be drinking with meals, it can actually prevent you from losing weight. Because if you are eating and then you're kind of flushing your stomach out with the liquid, it's gonna help it kind of go through your stomach faster. And remember, our stomachs are already pretty small. So that is why they always recommend, the doctors, they recommend that you wait 30 minutes before eating so you can drink, and then you have to wait 30 minutes to eat again. And then after you eat, you also have to wait another 30 minutes before you eat again. So eating and drinking before and after 30 minutes. The next thing that I feel is really important is a great tip that I have come up with, and this has helped me tremendously in my weight loss journey. And this tip is keep reminding yourself that the food is not going anywhere. So what I mean by that is, in the beginning, it's going to be really hard because you're not going to be able to eat a lot of your favorite foods. And I know, because I see on Facebook in the groups that I'm in, so many people, they crave pizza, they crave Chinese food, you know, you're going to get these cravings, and that is totally normal. So what I like to do is I like to keep it in my head, if I want Chinese food and, you know, maybe that doesn't fit into my plan for the day or the week, I will say to myself, okay, Chinese food is always going to be there, and just because I can't have it today doesn't mean that I'm never going to be able to have it. For whatever reason, when I tell myself those things, it just really helps me, because it feels like I'm not losing anything or I'm not giving anything up, because I know that it's still going to be there. And yes, I still do enjoy to eat out. Sometimes I have Chinese food. Basically, at this point, 2.5 years, I can eat whatever I want. It's not really a matter of what I can't eat. It's still me having to make those healthy choices. So if you are just beginning, just know that even though you are getting weight loss surgery, even a procedure like the sleeve, that is not going to prevent you from being able to eat junk food or unhealthy foods. You're still going to be able to eat those foods. So it's still going to be up to you to make those choices. And continuing to remind yourself that the food, the snacks, you know, the cookies and the sweets, those things are never going to go anywhere. And eventually you will be able to enjoy a snack. Another thing that I want to mention with that is, If you are craving something, I would definitely suggest trying to find a healthy alternative to your favorite snacks. So for me, instead of, you know, just eating regular cookies, I will try to find like a sugar-free option or something that's low fat. And I also still like to buy like 100 calorie packs because I find that having something that's already portioned out really helps keep it under control for me. So if you can tell yourself, you know, that the snacks aren't going anywhere when you are craving those snacks, I hope that can help you. And if not, try to find a healthy, sugar-free alternative to your favorite snacks. The next thing that I'm going to talk about is making sure that you are moving your body as much as possible. And what I mean by that, it doesn't necessarily have to mean exercising. So I would suggest that you try to not be inactive and you just try to be active as much as you can. So whether that is taking a walk around the block, maybe you will clean your house a little bit extra. Me, I aim to clean like one or two rooms in my apartment per day just because I know light cleaning is something that's going to keep me active. Vacuuming, mopping, things like that, that you really don't even think it's exercising. As long as you're keeping your body moving, you are burning calories and that is going to help you lose weight. So you can do something like that. Of course, you can do at-home workouts. I do them also. If you've seen my other video, I will show you the workouts that I do. And if you haven't seen it, I will link it down below for you in the description box. So I generally like to do Pop Sugar Fitness. Those videos are really fun for me. And if not, I will just, you know, put on some music, dance around my house. Like I said, anything to get your body moving that is going to help you keep losing weight. So the next tip that I have is embracing the process. The journey is going to look different for each and every one of us. I remember when I had my surgery, I would look at other people so often just to see if I was kind of like on the right track. And yes, it did help me, but at the same time, I don't think that it's really good to compare yourself or your progress to other people. You really should embrace the process. This is your own personal journey and it looks unique for every one of us. Just because somebody else is losing weight quicker doesn't make your surgery or your journey any less worthy. So enjoying the process and embracing it is really a beautiful thing to do for yourself to get started on this process. So I hope that you enjoy these tips that I have. And if you would like to see more videos like this, please don't forget to hit that like button and drop me a comment down below if you have any more questions. I will see you all in my next video.